All right, guys, hello and welcome to another day of just crazy trading. Obviously, GameStop, that's all everyone's talking about right now is GameStop, and for good reason. It made another crazy run today with a high of about $380 on the day, and yeah, you best bet I traded it. Oh yeah, I did. crazy day of trading in GameStop today, and just like you know, the day before that, and the day before that, and the day before that. But you know, today was a little different because when the stock's at like $300, it becomes a little bit different to trade. And in this video, I really want to talk about, you know, how to trade, how to day trade GameStop, because there are a few things that I've noticed over the last few days that have persisted day after day after day. Certain traits about GameStop that that are patterns that I've noticed that make for really good entries and really good trade decisions on the stock, and certain behavioral traits that GameStop keeps, you know, behaving in certain ways again and again and again. So as usual, I kind of want to go through my trades for the day in this recap. So before we get into GameStop, I want to go really quickly into Microsoft, which I had a couple brief trades on, and they just did not go my way. I tried to go long here on this little pullback and look for some continuation on this, which I didn't find. Had to stop out here. Looked for it long on the bounce on VWAP. Went for a pretty small size on this little teaser trade that didn't work out. Stopped out on that, and unfortunately, that is my biggest loss on the day, $175. If you look here on the monitor tab, Microsoft doesn't show up because I actually have a swing trade on this. And so my day trades in this actually show up in this section. So basically what that means is this number here is my number, is my gain for the day, day trading minus 175, what I lost on games, what I lost on Microsoft, excuse me. So about $590 of gain on the day in total day trading today, because it's 764 minus the 175 I lost on Microsoft. So let's get into GameStop. That's really the all everyone's talking about. Of course, there are other stocks that are just blasting through the moon right now. It's GameStop, it's Nokia, it's AMC, it's Bed Bath & Beyond, it's BlackBerry. KOSS had a crazy day today as well, coming into the close and just having a crazy after hours run. Let's talk about GameStop one thing at a time. I woke up in the middle of the night and I see this thing coming up again in pre-market, spiking in the pre-market and having a crazy run up here at 4 or 5 a.m. Obviously, I'm asleep. I did not trade it in here. But crazy action when I woke up. I thought, man, this is going to be fun to trade tomorrow. But back of mind, I'm thinking, okay, up at $360, the spreads are going to start to come into play, and that's one of the attributes, one of the things that that you have to keep in mind trading this. And you know, once you get up in those higher price ranges, the spreads on a stock that's $300 and moving around quickly, those spreads are going to be pretty vicious. So you have to be very careful about your entries and exits, and you can't quite trade it like it's a $50-$60 stock anymore. It's a $300, it's a $200 stock, and the spreads are something to consider. My first trade on this was actually pre-market, little dip trade here, put me up $180 on the day. My first trade, 20 shares, which is a pretty decent size on a stock priced above $300 and moving around quickly. So quick dip trade on this put me up 180, and then unfortunately these trades in here, I kind of gave some of that back, right here giving a little bit of profit back, and then right here on 20 shares in at 288, and then having to stop out at 275 down here. I should have given it a little bit more room, should have been a little bit more patient with it. I guess I wasn't. I had the right idea. We got that curl back up. Luckily I re-entered long right here for 10 shares at back in at 288. Same entry as before, this time carrying it higher and higher. I only wish that I took 10 shares here and 20 shares here, but instead I got 20 shares here and 10 shares here. Oh well. But this 10 share trade was enough to put me green from this loss on the 20 shares, and taking profits all along the way. So it definitely feels good when you are a part of that run up in the squeeze on GameStop. It seems like every day it's kind of had that squeeze at some point in the day. Today, I feel like it stopped a little bit short. We didn't get that break of the pre-market high at 280, 285. It did test that multiple times, but eventually it kind of gave in. I stopped out on, my last share there here at 347 from a 288 entry. that is pretty sweet. Here I actually took a very quick trade here in 5 shares, looking for that break of 380, not getting it, but still getting profit on 5 shares there of just a couple bucks. There's some really interesting dip trades in here, and this is one of those attributes, one of those traits of GameStop that I really want to focus on today, is those dips. GameStop has been exceptional at getting bought up on those dips. Every time it dips, you can just be a buyer. It seems like every time it dips, it pops back up and you just facepalm yourself thinking, why the heck did I not buy that dip? It was so juicy, so lucrative, and I just didn't take it. So after that trade, I was up on this stock, somewhere in the 200, almost $300 range, somewhere in there. Little dip trade in here, 20 shares out for just a few cents on this, a little bit of profit there. This trade in at $10, at 311, and then having to stop out at 302, took a pretty big hit on that, almost $100 on loss on that. But then there's that dip. I'm out at 302 on right here on this drop, and then I see it dip all the way down. I'm a buyer on this dip as it comes back up through 287. I buy the ask and I'm out at 302. I could have carried this one up a little bit further up to 310, but I got out at 302. The difference between 287 and 302 is about $15, whereas the difference between 311 and 302 is about $9. So all in all, between these two trades, profitable on 10 shares. Didn't really trade it in the afternoon as it kind of chopped around here. Looked for it right here to kind of... oof, this is nasty. Right here, looking for it to kind of continue higher as it bounces again off VWAP. The more times it's bouncing on VWAP, it's holding up, it's not breaking down. This is another trade of GameStop that we've seen over the last few days. It not breaking down early in the day. It doesn't break down early in the day. That's a sign that's consolidating. Buyers are holding the price, and it's all that time is generating more and more chances for it to come into a squeeze where we can really get that momentum to the upside. That's what I'm looking for here, is a higher high squeezing up. But unfortunately on this one, we broke down and failed. And this one, I took a pretty big hit. I was up about 360 bucks on it coming into this trade, and then with 10 shares, 388, and then stopping out for a $14 per share loss on 10 shares is $140 loss. And that put me back down to about only $220 or $240 in the green on the stock. Coming down through VWAP here, didn't take any dip trades on this as it was coming down. And then as it kind of geared up for that squeeze up, I was watching it here. I wanted to enter it here, but didn't. And then I missed out on this big spike up from up 310 to 323. But then as it kind of gained some momentum here, I'm a buyer on this pullback at 317. Really beautiful entry here on this pullback right at the bottom of this candle, coming back up, squeezing up, taking profit along the way. My entry's at 317, still taking profit here as it's coming down, consolidating, and then I stop out on the last of my shares right here, my last 2 shares at break even right here as it comes back down to my 317 entry. Bounces right back up. Okay, looks like it's consolidating again, setting up. All of this is juicy, bullish consolidation. I kind of regret the fact that I sold out right here. Shouldn't have really been a seller here until it really broke below VWAP. That should have been my sign to get out. I got out a little bit prematurely there. But then, in for 30 shares, pretty really some aggressive size on my part and my risk tolerance. 30 shares, you're losing $30 per dollar drop or gain. You're gaining $30 for every dollar that it goes up. GameStop is a huge mover today, so pretty aggressive size. Not super aggressive, but decent size there on 30 shares. But on this one, I took my profit too quickly. I took 30 shares. I knew I was taking a little bit bigger size. So in my mind, I'm thinking, there's definitely some risk involved with this trade, and for that reason, I want to take profits early or take some of my trade out early to lock in those gains. And I was looking here for that breakthrough, that bullish setup, that consolidation, that setup, looking for that breakthrough, and a really, really nice entry here at 327, right about here at the top of this candle, and then getting that continuation up. Just beautiful candle here, and then getting out for 2/3 of my entire position right here, not even at the top of this candle, right here about in the middle of this candle. I got out of half of my position, so good profit on that. $5 per share on 20 shares is $100, but definitely I missed out on a lot of profit that if I maybe should have taken a little bit less off the table instead of 20 shares. I got out at 10 at a time. I was holding 30. Not a great choice. Out 2 shares. Now I'm only holding 8, taking profit all the way up here. My best exit was 349. I was able to get out up here on this candle, 349, a couple of shares there. So imagine if I'd held some more shares up into those high 340s, that would have been really nice. But really not getting that, you know, that squeeze and continuation up into to 380s, back toward those highs. And so we kind of broke back down. And then here, I believe I was holding 1 share left into this dip. I was holding 8 shares after this, 6 shares, 7 shares, 5 shares. So maybe I was holding about 5 shares in this dip. I'm not really sure. Anyway, regardless, huge break down here. But once again, just be a freaking buyer in these dips, man. I buy 5 shares on this dip at 328. It breaks down all the way to 320. I'm able to actually get out at 329 for a $5 gain here on $1 per share gain on 5 shares is a $5 gain. And then here, getting out at 333 on a few more shares here left over from this entry here of 30 shares. So getting out kind of in here. And then chopping around. That was the big trade for me there. I think I was holding 1 share left that I got out at the best exit on this from this original $30 entry all the way back here. Got out at 360 on my very last share. And then into the after hours trading, it was really looking like it was dying out, and the volume was dying out really in here. But then we had this news that Wall Street Bets, the forum went private, and you can no longer view any content on there or participate in any of the forums there for a short period of time. It's back up right now, but this caused the stock to drop all the way back down, all the way down to 217. I bought a dip here at 238 with just 1 share. I'm taking very small size here, but all in all, I got out 1 share at 265. I was able to add about $29 of profit on top of the 572 I was up. I did trade a couple other stocks today. Nokia, I actually had $218 of profit on that. I'll show you those trades really quickly here. Traded this one beautifully as well. Bought a dip here. This one was a little bit iffy. I bought this candle. It came down lower all the way to 660, but then caught this pop back up. I was patient on it and getting my profits. Everything in here is green, all these exits, and just a really nice trade there. And then here, entering for 300 shares, being patient on it, taking some profit here. But unfortunately, I only took profit on this dip, and I didn't take profit on the way up. And so unfortunately I didn't have great exits on this, because I should have taken more out in front of 750, but I did not. Came in here and just anyway, taking profit all along the way. It hit a high of 777, and all of this is just profit taking, and then I was out of the trade, and that was it for Nokia. Did not make any higher highs throughout the day, so I'm really proud of my action on that. And and yeah, so that was pretty much my trading on the day. A couple small trades here that I won't get into, but anyway, yeah, just to summarize on GameStop, what we're seeing on this is a stock that you can seemingly buy the dip every single time. And by dip, I mean these candles, these 1 minute candles that just drop big time, and they just get bought up every single time. These dips just get bought, they just get bought. And then right here before the close as well, just getting bought up. And anyway, these dips are super lucrative. And so until we get action where we get halts going down, you know, these big, big candles coming down, this wasn't a halt, but there have been instances where it did halt going down like that. An example is, I believe right here, this is a halt going down, resumption, touch lower, and then boom, right back up. And this is what we've seen repeatedly on GameStop, is those halts going down and then the resumption higher. Another example right here, breakdown, halts going down, 5 minutes later, opening here and bouncing. And so it's almost as if you can just buy straight into the halt going down. As it's halting, there's a 15-second period before it actually halts trading to make sure that the buyers don't step up. And honestly, it's almost like you can just buy straight going into that halt. It's very tempting, because every single time it just seems to open higher or move higher. and the halt's going down. Do not kill this. Even if it's not halting, these big flushes just get bought back up instantly. So that's something I've noticed on GameStop over the past few days. It's not just today. There's plenty of examples of it today. This is another really great example. Huge drop here and then huge bounce. This is a $15 bounce. And so it happens repeatedly. It happened yesterday and it's happening today again. And really today you can look at as just entirely a period of consolidation. And then this bad news about the forum being going private, I'm not really sure if that's really all that bad news. It seems unrelated, really, and I don't think it really plays a big role. The forum is back up and running anyway, so you can go on there and but it's almost back up to really where it was trading in at around $315 in that aftermarket trading action. So tomorrow is anybody's guess. I honestly like it to the upside. I do, honestly. Anything can happen, but it's bouncing off of that $220 level and bouncing off that that $250 level, and I think that is a reasonably bullish sign. And I think that tomorrow it's really anybody's guess, and certainly on the daily chart this looks like a decently, obviously it's a bullish chart, and I think that this single day daily candle is a bullish candle, honestly. So it's I think that GameStop 500, GameStop to the moon, it's absolutely in the cards for tomorrow, but it's not obviously a surefire thing. Anyway, it will be very fun to trade tomorrow. But just to summarize those traits of how to trade GameStop: buy the dips until they stop working. If you do get the halt coming down on high volume and then the continuation coming out of the halt lower, then if we start to see those happening we start to see GameStop selling off aggressively, obviously that will be a sign that GameStop is the party's over. But if we do keep seeing that those halts going down, then they just get bought straight back up instantly, or if it doesn't halt and it just shoots back up and we keep getting those bounces, and really look for GameStop to just not break down. And by break down, I mean totally fall apart. As long as it holds around and doesn't drop more than $50 or $60 in the span of an hour, I'd say that it's bullish. Honestly, it has the potential for the squeeze. You see, I marked out in the morning this channel, and when we got the breakout of that channel, I'll show my trades again. That for me was, well, it's, I guess it's just being glitchy. It's only showing some of my trades now. Maybe if I change the time frame. Here we go. So as you can see here, when I was anticipating the breakout of this channel, I'm in for 10 shares, and you trade it like any other stock. You just look for those setups, break out of this channel, and it's a beautiful setup and a beautiful trade. That's just that. So trade it like any other stock, but look for those dips, and then look and at the larger picture and realize that this is really just a consolidation day. We didn't get that huge squeeze that we've gotten the past couple days, at least to the upside from the opening price. So look for consolidation, look for it to just not break down, and look for buying those dips, and be careful of the spreads, because if it does continue higher up to $500, it's gonna get really tricky to trade. Your entries are gonna be difficult and the spreads are gonna be horrific. So it'll get harder and harder to really manage your sizes, manage your liquidity and getting in and out on a stock that's priced that highly. But hopefully, this recap has been helpful for you, and I would have been remiss if I didn't make a recap on it because of all that's going on. The trading is just super fun over the last few days. I've been trading GameStop as long as it's been popping off like this, and it's been great to trade. I've made roughly $500 or $600 on it a day for the past like 3 days or what have you, I think I'll be excited to trade it tomorrow, and I'll probably wake up at 5 a.m. and just check my phone and what's going on in the pre-market, because I just won't be able to help myself. And because over the last couple of days, what we've seen is that in the pre-market, it's done crazy things in the pre-market, and I'll definitely be looking at it and be interested to see what price it opens at tomorrow morning. My guess is the 300s. Honestly, my guess is the 300s or high 200s, if not 400s. So we'll see. All right, guys. I hope this recap was helpful. If it was, please leave a like. I appreciate that very much. And subscribe if this content is helpful for you. I do recaps every single day, or I try. I do them most days. And I will see you guys tomorrow. I will be trading and I'll be having lots and lots of fun. I hope you guys will too. All right. Bye-bye.